went on a guided tour of Auschwitz and Birkenau. Although I did bring the camera with me, I didn't feel like taking time to record for this video would give the place the right reverence that it deserves. At this point, I thought I'd take a moment out to sum up the experiences that we had on the tour, especially seeing as it was the main event for our trip to Krakow. You guided around Auschwitz first, and coming out of that, I just couldn't find any words to say. Like at the Berlin Wall, I was silent for long periods that day. I couldn't get my head around the scale of the inhumanity. What do you say after all the things that you've only ever been told about the Holocaust are just put there in front of you? And as we were walking around Birkenau, I was thinking, what would be the appropriate response in the face of something like this that wouldn't just be violence breeding violence? It's a very humbling experience, especially when you're walking down paths that, as close as 70 years ago, other people were taking, unknowingly walking to their death. I had the thought, with the amount of people that took that path, my footsteps must be covering those of one of those people. After seeing what they had to go through, I count myself incredibly lucky. First of all, that I did that with friends. I feel like it would have been much harder to do by myself. Secondly, how fortunate I am to have the relationships that I do with my family, with my girlfriend, and I still get to experience life. It's a really eye-opening experience, and it made me appreciate everything that I have. On a lighter note, you'll see me now at the train station after we left the camp, trying to sum up everything into one facial expression. Time to get back to the video. On the night train from Krakow to Vienna, we made an incredible discovery. Somebody told us that if we were to reach under the seats, we could recline them to make three beds across the compartment. This was a revelation because the previous night train we'd taken was so uncomfortable that most of us had terrible sleep. So this time, although we were tired, we were excited to look forward to relatively comfortable sleep.
It's okay.
Hello.
No, Scott's more interesting.
Yeah, he's way more interesting.
So, Scott. What do you want from me?
That's a nice shirt you got there.
I want some kind of barking seal. You can put a camera in front of and make me do things for your entertainment.
I was just complimenting your shirt.
Thanks.
Next stop, Vienna. See you in the next video.